Proverbs 18:22 tells us that he who finds a wife finds a good thing and obtains favor from the Lord. Although many of us view the word find in this scripture to mean an act of seeking or journeying to discover, I look at it in a different lens. When it comes to you, I think about what I find in you that has led us to this moment of us becoming husband and wife. I find you to be beautiful both inside and out. I'm grateful for the beauty God has shown me both internally and externally by having the opportunity to see your face and be in your presence. I find you to be the most loving, caring, and trustworthy woman I've ever been in a relationship with. The fact that you love me in spite of my bad days, shortcomings, and bad decisions gives me confidence that you will continue to partner with me and help me grow as I will help you to do the same. I find you to be my constant reminder that God is good and He hears my prayers. As your husband, I vow to listen to you regardless of whether I like what you have to say or not. I vow to be a rock for you in moments where you feel vulnerable, take care of you in mind, body, and soul, protect you from words or actions that mean you harm, and most importantly, making sure we acknowledge God in everything we'll encounter in life. We know that the enemy is busy, but with God on our side, there is nothing that we can't accomplish as a unified front. So in closing, thank you. Thank you for being my mirror, allowing me to see myself in the right and the wrong. Thank you for showing me that I still have lots of love to give. Thank you for changing me for the better and motivating me to always go for what God has for me. Thank you for your unwavering love. Thank you for being my girlfriend.
You would take away the pain.
Take away the pain.
Through the storm, the sun still shines. With you by my side, I'm not afraid. When I hear your name.
You always mention that I am your answered prayer. Before today, I often thought that I didn't specifically pray for you because I didn't list out qualities and attributes I wanted my future husband to have. I prayed for God to prepare me for my husband and to prepare my husband for me. I was praying for the process. I was praying for someone who would understand that love was a process. Someone who would understand that patience and communication are important to the process. I was praying for someone who would be committed to the process, and I know now that I was praying for you. And what a blessing you have been to me. I want to thank you for always being patient when I'm not. Thank you for all the small things, like making sure I ate, to buying me new bedroom shoes because you saw I needed some. Thank you for always considering me. Thank you for investing in my hobbies and celebrating my talents. Thank you for choosing to love me, even when I'm not always easy to love. In these 2 years together, I've realized that the preparation I was praying for is continuous. We've been preparing to be a spouse for each other every day, and that's not something that will ever end. I promise to communicate with you so we can navigate the good and the bad times. I promise to remember that as a provider, you still need provision. I promise to extend you grace and remember that neither of us are perfect. A simple friend request changed our lives and brought us here today, and there's no other place I'd rather be. You often ask me if I want to ride somewhere with you when you're about to leave, and my response is, always, I want to go where you go. You think it's a joke, but I truly mean it. I want to go where you go. Because where you go is peace and safety. I want to experience life with you, your life with you. I want to be there experiencing every success, every pain, every breakthrough, and every piece of joy that you do. I want to be right by your side wherever you go. Wherever life takes you, whatever life hands you, I will be wherever you go. In your corner, by your side, wherever you go. Because wherever you go is home. I love you.
Love you too.
I love you. You did work today, but then you do it great, but you're always there. Now I'm going to be your favorite. All right, talk to you later.
I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Anthony Bradford Mitchell.
Talk to me, even when you're not all around, I feel you, boy, I feel you, boy, yeah. Tangled in your love and your energy, perhaps it was the way that you smile. I see you, boy, oh, I need you, boy, yeah, yeah, yeah. I've been waiting my whole life to find someone like you, find someone. Perfect, but you're perfect to me. Been asleep, you're a dream. I need you. Though we got a past, I want you. And even when it's bad, I love you. I've been waiting my whole life to find someone like you. Find someone like you. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I've been waiting my whole life to find someone like you. Find someone.
Oh. I really love you. You should know. I wanna make sure I'm right, boy, before I let go. Now we had a good time that we can say. We heard in each other, yeah. And boy, it's a shame. I won't be foolish, no. I wanna know. I wanna make sure I'm right.
She came home smiling, and all I remember her It was incredible to watch my friend change before my eyes. I love seeing her smile and beam of true happiness. Everyone here knows how contagious and huge Spechel's smile is, and it hasn't changed one bit. In fact, I haven't seen a man make her smile since her father, and my shared wish is that he was here to be Mitch. I knew Mitch was someone that could make my friend happy for the rest of her life, and you are deserving of that everlasting love. Mitch, I just want to say thank you. Thank you for loving my friend. Thank you for coming to her life and accepting her for all that she is. Thank you for accepting me and Lennox, because with Spechel comes to both of us too. Lennox is my dog. Spechel nothing. You are an amazing man, friend, and I know you are going to be an amazing husband. To me, to Spechel, you both look absolutely amazing today. I like you. I like to wish you two all the love and happiness in the world. I know there are many happy years ahead for you. Let's all raise our glasses to the bride and groom and wish them a lifetime of love and happiness.
Yeah. How's everybody doing today?
Good.
I'm Jared, the best man slash best friend slash, well, my brother.
There you go, Jared.
Words can describe how much this man has been a part of my life.
There we go.
I really couldn't ask for a better best friend. And God thought to my kids, because he's been there since day one through all my hard times. And Mr. and Mrs. Mitch been like a second parent to me, like since the Salmon days, since Parker Middle School, since him coming to my football games. They've been like a second parent, and of course, you know, they're Tar Heels fans, so that always helps. I'm sorry. I just want to say I'm proud of my brother. I wish y'all nothing but happiness. Spechel, you're really living up to the name. Spechel, because I'm like, what's her name? You're like, Spechel. I'm like, oh, word, that's her name for real. love y'all both. And if he acts up, you know, I'm a phone call away. You know, Grandpa's right down the road, so you know, I'll pull up.
That's a fact.
Yeah. So I love you both. And when y'all go to Mexico, make little Mitches. I will be there for y'all kids, just like Brad has always been there for mine.
Spechel and I became friends in kindergarten at Northwest Elementary School. Aside from my husband, whom I met in kindergarten as well, my friendship with Spechel has the most longevity, with almost 25 years of memories and milestones. In 2019, I got married and moved away to Illinois. Every year since, I tried to come home, but things never seemed to work out. Finally, after 3 long years, I have made it back to NC.
Yes, ma'am.
Ain't no better place.
There is no way I could miss Spechel's Spechel day. Spechel is a dependable friend, and she is always there. Whenever her friends have events or major life accomplishments, she is right there to celebrate with them. So I had to make sure I was here to celebrate with Spechel on her big day. Throughout the years, Spechel and I have seen each other through several relationships and situationships. But I knew there was something different about Mr. Mitchell. When Spechel publicly posted their Christmas photos in 2019, I knew she was serious about Mitch because she does not do that. I know my friend Spechel very well. She is smart, loving, sassy, and at times stubborn. I knew she needed a man who could love, appreciate, and handle all her amazing and unique qualities. And Mitch is definitely the man for the job. Technically, this time formally meeting Mitch. However, I already consider him my brother. I remember around this time last year, he called me and told me he was going to propose to Spechel. During our conversation, we discussed many things, but I want to say this again publicly. Mitch, thank you for taking care of my friend and loving her the way she deserves to be loved. We all know Mr. Malcolm loved his youngin' and would do anything for her and vice versa. I know he was smiling down on this union because God sent his youngin' a good man. Mitch and Spechel, continue to put God first, and he will continue to bless your marriage. I pray you have 50 plus years of marital bliss.
Thank you.